Colin McAlpine has transformed a grazing property with plenty of grass and broadleaf weeds into a cropping enterprise with only a few weeds, while protecting the efficacy of all available herbicides.
I moved closer to the coast for rainfall and for no frost, but I bought a property that was basically a grazing property with a lot of weeds. I knew that when I bought it, and it was challenging. I felt there was no herbicide resistance. There was very basic herbicide resistance, so I had a clean sheet as far as that went. But there were certain things that I wanted to do. I didn't want to dry seed. I hated dry seeding where I used to farm. I felt that was the problem, start of all our problems. It added to our herbicide resistance just by dry seeding. You had too much reliance on herbicides up front. And I felt in a higher rainfall area, I could wait, get more weeds up, and then hopefully kill more before the crop goes in. And it has taken a long time, and I'm very disciplined with my rotation. I do a long rotation, and when I use a herbicide that works, I try not to use it again for 3 or 4 years. I have lowered the seed bank, definitely, and that's just been through rotation, crop rotation, herbicide rotation, and double knocking, and trying to, it's a numbers game. It is purely a numbers game. I'm disciplined with my timing of knockdown sprays. I do wait when I get a really good weed kill, I get one. And then when I do my second, my double knock, I do wait 10 days. I get a big rainfall event, I write on the calendar, 10 days from now I start spraying and then I start seeding.
Colin uses a variety of weed control tactics, but also sees great value in investing in crop nutrition and soil health as critical elements in managing weeds across all soil types.
So I have a complete 4-year rotation, and the canola is the start of my 4-year plan for a paddock. Canola is my major tool. I like to put canola in, and I do smack it with a kitchen sink. Yeah, basically I basically am a wheat farmer, so all the stuff I do is because my barley and my canola and my lupins, they're all really aimed for the wheat. I'm a wheat grower, and I have sheep, and sheep are in that, like livestock are part of that plan. They go over the stubbles, they stir all their little hooves stir all the ground up and stimulate all the weeds to germinate. They play a part. Just the animals, I believe animals, their little destructive little hooves, as much as they are destructive, do stir the ground up and help stimulate germinate the weeds when it first rains. When we swath, I'd spray under the swath, and then I do follow up with sheep. I put ewes on that sprayed swath underneath. I do change my chemical group the year after canola when it goes into wheat. I don't use that chemical group for another 4 years. Your sprayer is critical. Your droplet size, your pressure, your boom pressure, your amount of water that you use. You've got to keep your water rates up. You've got to use high water rates, high pressure, and controlled droplet. But it's all about the timing and getting the herbicide on at the right time, under the right conditions, with the right amount of water. My cost of production has come back and my yields have increased with smarter use of herbicides and nutrition and soil health, for sure. Yeah, I'm definitely more efficient now at what I'm doing. This farm gets lime every 4 years. Soil pH, soil health, soil nutrition and herbicide use, it's all the big picture. And that has been massive. I can market with confidence now because I believe I'm close enough to the coast to guarantee a certain type of rainfall. And I can market with some confidence now knowing I'm going to produce X amount of grain because I know my weeds aren't going to wipe me out. So if you get a herbicide that works really well, then just don't use it again the next year. Keep it. Keep that up your sleeve because you know that down the track, if you use it the next year and the next year, within 4 years you can't use it anymore. But if you use it once in 4, you better use it for the next 16 years.